Welcome back to Let's Play Amberstar Blind. This is the RPG chick, Amethyst Lunatari. I know at the end of the last episode I said we were going to the Dwarven Mines. I could not find my way there. From what we have labeled on the map, I could actually show you. That's the beauty of recording in a window like this. Dwarven Mine's supposed to be here. Here's Twin Lake. I'm thinking this is in the middle. You really need to see it because the original map, which I could find, but I don't feel like... Oh, look at that. Tower of White Weirds. I think the Dwarven Mines is in the middle, because the text might be obscuring it a little bit. I could find another copy of the map, but eh. I think it's in here. I've been all around this area. I've been over here. Actually, I figured this wasn't the right mountain range, so I ended up going all over the place and ended up down here, outside the tomb of the Pharaoh, and fought three skeletons, which they usually show up in multiples of four? Or six? I think four. And then fought four, and eight, and a dozen. So, yeah, multiples of four. But here we got three. I fought them. Got, you know, some stuff. It wasn't anything. They were just skeletons. Normal variety. And that's the Tomb of the Pharaoh there, underneath the mountain range to just to the south of it here, like in the mountains. So, I couldn't find my way in here. We might need to get a different mode of transportation or find it later or something like that. But we're like around here, I believe, with this river coming up. So I'm going to the Riddlemaster's Islands. Yay, riddles. So I'm gonna head over there and tackle that and try to get what's his name's harp back. Kelvin? Is that his name? Can't really put the horse on the boat, can we? It's gonna damage us a little bit. Well, maybe not. It's a jaunty jig. So yeah, that's a whole 20 minutes of an episode that I cut out because... Well, that would have been boring as hell to see that. I don't want to overshoot the island. Is this supposed to be the island? Oh no. No, I don't think it is. This Sansri's Island is ringed by mountains. The boat screams, ouch! So it's by the Tower of the Black Wizards, that whole area. Well, across the water from it, of course. It was annoying as hell looking for this place. Just gotta say. But apparently we're not meant to go there yet. I think we have to pass over the mountains. And there is an aerial mode of transportation. I think this is the island? Sansri's Island? Yeah, it's gotta be, because there's more this way. Let's find the land again. Did I overshoot this whole thing? Oh no, this must be it. It's so hard because... Yeah, I know where we are. We're like less than halfway there. You want to zoom out so you can see more of the land. But you can't! You cannot zoom out. So you have to just compare land masses to what I'm having on what I see on the map on the other monitor. Which I'm glad I have another monitor. Well, I would just print it out, but... Since I don't have a color printer, technically I have access to a color printer, but I get in trouble with that. Now some of you may be wondering, why doesn't she have a printer? I hardly ever have to print anything, that's why. I never find myself needing to print something. Where am I? Is this where the... Okay. That's good to know. I thought I was not that far along. So if you pretty much head diagonal from here, we might find it. Might. Or we could completely overshoot it, because we're in the middle of the water and there's no reference point. Oh, this might be it. Can I put this on this? No. You got blasted there. Could this be the place? Let me just look over here. See if there's anything. No. Pretty small island. Tower of Riddles! Exciting. You see, we are down a little bit in spell power. We got hurt from going across. Wow, really? That much? 13 points. Tempted to just sleep a little bit, but eh. We'll just be careful. We'll have to rest, I'm sure. Soon, I'm sure. The Tower of the Riddles. Okay. So you'd think I'd be heading north because I came in that way, but... Heading north. But we're traveling west. You hear gentle harp music. Oh. Kelvin's harp, I presume? Finding no traps? So am I trying to pick a lock by doing this? Am I using a lockpick? That's no good. We need a key to get in this place. When we go near here, we hear music every time. Huh. Do you have any other kind of key? Another key. I tried it, didn't work. Okay, here's another island. It did say Riddlemaster's Islands, not Island. I got blasted again. House of the Riddlemaster. Okay. We got a puzzle mouse. Who has sent you? Kelvin. Kelvin was probably too afraid to come himself. Well, then come in. The real master awaits you. Okie dokie. A door as well. Anything in these barrels? Guess not. This is another. Guess that's him over there. I suppose there's gonna be secret stuff I can just walk through. Sarath. Age 60, human male. I'm trying to scroll with my mouse wheel. That does not work. Welcome, I am Sarath, the Riddlemaster. As I see, Kelvin is not with you, but I am prepared to give him one more chance if you succeed in conquering the riddles. If you can find the harp, you can either give it back to Kelvin or keep it yourselves. But you need this key to reach the tower. If you solve the riddle of the tower, come back to me, show me the harp, and I will reward you. Tower key. He'll say nothing about Kelvin. I spelled riddles wrong. Nothing about that. About Amberstar. I don't suppose he says anything else then. Just had to get here, come here to get the key. riddles go, there isn't much of one. I can't get on from here. I have to go into the water and hurt myself. I didn't hurt this time. Alright, the... You barely see where I'm going. That hurt. I wonder if he'll be Ouch. I wonder if he'll be fighting anything, or just doing riddles. There we go. I wasted a torch on that. The item opens the door. Hooray! Okay. Hi. I am the first riddle you must solve. Everyone listens to it, again and again, though it never says a single word. Guess, what is so silent? In sleep you lie upon it. Now what may that be? Everyone listens to it and never says a single word. In sleep you lie upon it. Alright, well, we don't listen to a pillow. Or a bed. Or a blanket. Just a guess here. Not the correct answer. Oops. Not the correct answer. Come back to this? I don't know. Everyone listens to it, but doesn't say a word. And it's silent. And we sleep on it. Oh, okay. We listen to it again and again. In sleep you lie upon it. I hate stuff like this, just gotta say. Okay. I will admit, I had to consult a walkthrough, but I didn't look any further than what the answer was. Ear. We listen to it, it's silent, we sleep on it. I mean, unless you sleep on your back, or with your face smushed into the pillow. Yes, that was what I wanted to hear. The path is now clear. It leads to the next puzzle, but danger is now where before there was none. Danger, okay. Oh, I see. Is it here? Ah. Oh. Furry rats. Attack. Oh my god. That's a lot of freaking rats. I'm not sure how tough these are. This is the early level variety, or these are tougher. Throw a fireball here on that whole row. Let's just stand by and see how tough these guys are. Giant rats. The other ones are cave rats, right? They're all lined up like that. 13 points takes one out. Oh, wow. Okay. Not bad at all. They're gonna move, so I'm just gonna sit here. Or they're gonna flee. Okay. Half of them lose morale. Bleep. I think they have three eyes. Oh, this one fails? I always got one straggler. Alright. You call that danger? If they had stayed and fought us, we would get 60 experiences then. At least they have gold. Okay, that was easy enough. Okay, we've been there. It's all the doors confuse me because they don't show up on the map. Stairs. That is a hole. Let's not fall down that unless we really want to. We'll have no choice. Ah, more rats! Gonna be the same. Was there less than this? Less this time. We got two missing. Oh, they're advancing. Look at that. These ones aren't losing morale. They're braver. So we can pretty much one-shot kill them. Let's attack different ones. Oh, actually, it hit both of us. Swamp rats. Oh, these are swamp rats. Oh, these are tougher. So you have swamp rats hiding behind the giant rats. Note to self, swamp rats are a little tougher. Still kicking. 23.7. 25. Okay. That one's down. Gonna save up my spells and not use them like crazily. Yeah, I gotta move him over. Here's gonna be a reckoning in store. Or whatever. Whatever I'm trying to say. One more. Try to start healing him, I guess. Healing two. Swamp Rat casts a spell. I guess nothing happened. Damn these rat spellcasters. We got 61 that time. 118 gold, not bad. 18 rations. You feel a slight draught of air. Yep, we went through the wall. Illusory wall. Oh, interesting. Hi. I am the first part of the riddle. I am the first part of the second riddle. It flew featherless into a tree leafless. But who ate it? A human being. Okay, something that flies, which is not a bird, into a tree, which has no leaves. What? I am no good at this stuff. It flew featherless. So how would something fly? By being thrown? Into a tree without leaves. But who ate it? Okay. Who ate it? Meaning some kind of animal, maybe? Okay, so something that flies that doesn't have wings could be a fly, some kind of bug, insect, into a tree leafless, but who ate it? I don't know about the tree thing, but we'll try frog, because does he eat insects? Not the correct answer. You have to wait for the lips to move. Okay, I did look at a walkthrough again. It flew featherless into a tree leafless. But who ate it? I don't know what it is. The night? I don't know. But the answer, who ate it, is sun. The sun ate it. A part of your path is now clear, but you will not get far unless you find the second part. Thank you. Madness. I understand.